بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. کلاس 8 چیپٹر 2 وی ور گوئنگ تھرو ایم ایس ایکسس 2013 ڈیزائن ویو اینڈ تھیوریز. ناؤ وی آر گوئنگ ٹو ایکسپلین اباؤٹ ڈیزائن ویو. سم مور تھنگز آر دیئر. دیز آر بیسکلی فیلڈ پراپرٹیز. وی ہیڈ آلریڈی سین بیسکلی کہ فیلڈ پراپرٹیز پین از دیئر in the design view option of Microsoft Access. So in this video we are going to discuss different properties which are there for the fields that we mention for any entity in a table. There are different field properties. What are these field properties and what are the objectives of those field properties, we are going to discuss over here. I will open Microsoft Access file of the same data that was employee information. I will right click on it. I will go to the design view, and over here we have different fields available. Now in this table you will see that employee ID is auto number. So employee ID is auto number, and employee name is short text, date of joining is date and time, salary is in number, grade is in lookup wizard that is now being shown as the short text. Now we have to apply these properties. Number one is field size. What is meant by field size? For example, if I say employee name is short text. You will see over here field size is by default 255 characters, means a number of characters are there. Let's suppose if I want to restrict the field size over here 20, then it will allow only 20 characters in the field name. Or if I write 30, then it will allow only 30 characters, and you cannot enter more than 30 characters in the field employee name. This is how field size works. I hope you have got this point, how field size works. We can also give the field size in the numbers even. For example, employee salary. Field size is long integer right now. We can increase its length up to double. So then its size will be increased. So it is also available, means the field size is also available in the employee, in the number data type, in the employee information table. We can also apply it on the number data type. Means it is applied on the text as well as on number data type. Now come towards the format, how the data will be displayed, what will be the format of the data. It is basically applied on, for example, date of joining. Now we have got different formats to write dates. You will see here that format option is there. If we go to this option, you will see different formats of writing dates. For example, long date, first day come, then comma, then month name, then date, and then year. It's a long date. Medium date, normally we write in the medium date, 12-November-15. So first you are writing the day, then you are writing the month, and then you are writing the year. So this is called a medium date. So in this way we can select any option that we want. For example, I select medium date over here. So formats can also be applied on the currency. We have got different currency types like dollar sign, pound sign. So some different options are available. Now come to the option which is called input mask. What is meant by input mask? Input mask is used when we want to give the data some kind of format, which is basically, let's suppose we add another field over here with the name of phone number. Phone number is there, and I am going to select over here number. Now, what is basically the purpose of input mask? How you are going to write the phone number? So over here, if you see that input mask property is there, I have selected over here phone. I am going to the input mask option. Input mask means ke how the data will be available to you. In which format? Okay, I close this table and I again open it in the design view. The input mask works only with the text or date field types. So I will have to select over here text. Fine. It is giving an error on the number, so I'm going to select the text. Okay, let's suppose I have to apply input mask on it. I'm going to select the input mask option. Now these are different input mask options available over here. How you are going to show your phone number? Let's suppose this is the format that I want to have. I will say, okay, first there will be country code and then the number will come. We can also change this option. We can have any other option as well. So I'm going to apply this input mask. Let's suppose if some password is there, so then we can apply password mask, which is basically used to show asterisks instead of the number. So what I have done, I have selected this phone number input mask. I will say next. Now how many digits are there? You can see over here, you can increase the digits according to your country. Three numbers are there for the country code, and then seven numbers are there for the number. If you want to increase it, if it is not seven, you can increase it up to eight or any other number. I will say next. This is basically the character that we are using between these numbers. Let's suppose if we are using these characters, so hyphen symbol is there, we are using hyphen symbol over here. So this is the way that the phone number will appear in the input mask. I will say next. And with the symbol in the mask, so parenthesis and hyphen sign will appear now because we have given this input mask over there. So parenthesis and hyphen sign will appear. I will say next. So then in this situation, I will say finish. So I have applied the input mask on the phone. We will enter some data in order to understand how this input mask will work. Now it is showing you that you can enter data in the form where you will enter the country code in the parenthesis, then number, then dash, then numbers. Three numbers, then dash, then four numbers. Then come towards another option, which is called caption. Caption is also there. What is meant by caption? Caption is basically the heading. For example, employee salary. This is the EMP salary. But in the caption, I can mention over here completely employee. It will be only heading, employee salary. Now, the employee salary will be actually the option that we have mentioned as heading. This is basically heading, but actual field name will remain same. That is employee salary. Employee salary will remain same, the field name, but its heading will become employee salary. Now we go to the another option, which is default value. What is meant by the default value? If someone wants to give some default value, default value means ke if the user doesn't enter, what will be the value? This is called default value. For example, in the field of city, I can mention default value Muscat, but if the user wants to change, he can. But default value will be that value which will be already mentioned. So I am going to give in my database in the field of employee salary. Okay, I give a default value that there should be at least default value 2000, means there would be at least salary 2000. If you want to change it or if you want to increase the value, you can, but it will be the default value. Default value means already displayed value. And user can change it. If user doesn't want to change it, user can leave it the same value. For example, if you are giving the default value city Muscat in the field name city, then if the user wants to change it, he can. Otherwise, he will let it the same. Then come towards the validation rule. Validation rule means ke, if some rule is there that you want to apply. What is meant by validation rule? This is basically the next topic, which is validation rule. For example, if some salary is there, let's suppose, and if someone is giving salary, let's suppose 100, so 100 is not a proper salary and it is very less, so we can apply ke you cannot give this value, it should be at least 1000, greater than equal to 1000 for example. So it will, it should give some error message. Okay, what are you doing? This is not a proper value for this. This is called validation rule. For example, if I apply a validation rule over here in this way, okay, it should be greater than equal to 100. The salary should be greater than equal to 100. If some user is entering, let's suppose 25 or 50 or 30, we will say no, it is not a valid salary. Why? Because it is not following the rules of the country, for example, or the rules of the organizations. So in this situation, we can apply some validation rule in order to take input for correct data. Validation rule is there in order to take input for the correct data. So if we apply over here greater than 100, it should be greater than 100. If you are entering less than 100, it is invalid. What is meant by validation text? This is validation text. Validation text means when you are not following the validation rule, what will be the error message? I am writing over here. I enter correct salary in the field. You are not entering correct salary. You are entering the correct salary, which is less than even 100. So it is not correct. So validation text will appear as a message in order to inform the user that this is basically not correct data that you are entering. Then there are two more properties required. Required means ke if you are saying ke this is compulsory to enter data over here in this field. For example, employee name. I click on employee name and I select over here required. Required yes means ke you have to enter data over here. You have to enter data over here and you cannot leave it blank. You cannot say, no, I don't have a name. The employee doesn't have a name. No, you have to enter data. For example, phone. Employee may say, okay, no, I don't have the cell phone. Let's suppose. So over here required is no, but in employee name required is yes, you have to enter data. And one more property is there, allow zero length. Allow zero length is basically, by default it is yes, but normally when we have applied required yes, so we say allow zero length should also be no. Why? Because you cannot say that someone is not writing anything in the field name and you are allowing the user to type zero characters. No, name cannot be a zero character length. So allow zero length will be no in this situation. The allow zero length will be no. So what are the properties that we have set over here? We have set these properties. You can see over here, field size we applied in the name, format we applied over here in date of joining. Then we applied the input mask on phone number. We applied the caption on employee salary. Then default value we applied on the salary. We gave over there 2000, and validation rule we also applied on the salary. We gave that the if the salary is greater than equal to 10,000, then it is okay. Otherwise you will give an error message using validation text. You will type the error message over there. Required means ke you have to enter data in this field. If you say required yes, then you have to enter data in this field. Allow zero length is applied on the field where you have set the required yes, because allow zero length will be no in that situation. Now we close this table. We have set certain properties. We say yes. And we open this table. Now, if you see, if I write field name, which is a long field name, Ahmed Khan, and afterwards I am writing some more text, it is not giving me permission to write text. Why? Because the data, you can see the beep, you can listen the beep, that the data is now more than 20 characters, so it is not allowing me. So I will reduce the text, keeping it less than 20 characters. I will type over here the salary CEO. date of joining. Now you will see that the date of joining is in a particular format, which is basically the same format that we have selected in the format. The format was medium date, where the month was coming in three letters. So it is showing me in the same format. If you see the caption of the salary property, employee salary is written in the full format. Employee salary, complete employee salary is written over here. And if you see the grade, grade may we have already taken some given options. So I'm going to take grade A. Phone number, you will see that it is showing you input mask. Now you can observe we had applied the input mask plus 968, and then I'm writing some number over here. So it will be entered accordingly. It will be entered accordingly. If we leave the name blank, it will not allow us. For example, if we don't write the name over here, it will give us error message because we are not following the rule. If we give the salary less than 100 and we go to the next option, next record, then even in that situation, there would be some error message and it will not allow us to enter the salary which is not according to the given criteria. So these all are the options that we have applied using field properties. I hope you will be able to apply these all options. You will enter at least 5 records in your table. And then you will save your table. I'm going to save the table. It will say yes. So now we have completed these properties. I hope you will be able to apply these all options of properties that we have gone through today. These are the properties that we have gone through today. And field size, format, input mask, caption, default value, validation rule, validation text, required, allow zero length. These all are the options that we have applied. I hope you will be able to apply these options on your PCs at your home. Thank you so much.